Hi, Tech Rabbit here.
Yeah.
We're gonna have some fun. Now, it's the next day is just to try and see how this case comes apart, and then we're gonna try and put the. I think we're gonna try and put a part of the power supply in, and then have a look at the fan positioning, and we'll call it on this video. So, let's start. What I'd like to show is how to turn it around. So, that's quite good. I have to look at the cell phone to make sure I get the picture in correct. Anyway, behind it here, you have this opening here, which you should open up because I've actually hidden some accessories in there. Oh, looks like it's zip tied in. Okay, need tools. I haven't rehearsed any of this, so this will just go the way it'll go. Okay, it wasn't in zip ties. Wires. Oh, one out. Goes to the side. And I just have a look and see what this box contains. I think this might be a SATA driver. Drive holder, I suppose. PSU installation. Ah, seems to have the instructions how to take it apart, how to install stuff. That's quite nice. And see, has the debowers. He wanted to have two power supplies. Could put two power supplies. Some screws. That's quite nice. Look at that. We shall see what screws they recommend. So I might actually be spending a little bit of time looking at that instruction. Look at that. Anything else in here? What in the world? Soft rubber bit. That's for. Okay, right now I don't know. Let's go. It's just a cable holder grip thing, I think, or two of them actually. Yeah. Velcro. No, it's actually three. Look at that. I actually have three Velcro scripts.
Strips.
A bit late in the evening. Okay, so that's that box. That. Okay, let's see what we can find here. So I think I'll just leave that cover off. And then do we have two bay locations for full size hard drives? Okay, that's good. So the full-size hard drive goes here and the PSU goes there. But anyway, let's continue. Let's not lose focus. We'll put these over here. Okay, and this is basically like you saw, this is tool-less disassembly. So we can actually, I think, unscrew those. What does one? Maybe one pulls at it. Oh, look at that. Okay. So, and these panels, I suggest the one puts in the box that it came with for now. This is worth showing. Let's see how to unassemble that. So you see here, we have the packing box. What I said, we're going to take all those panels and we're going to put them in between here, so that they're all safe in the box. Camera back where it belongs. This is a magnetic filter, so I'm actually just going to take it off. There's a damaged. Okay, let's see now then. And as you see, this is what I was looking for, lots of internal space. Really nice. This table is not very slippery for moving things. But if I understand, then one should be able to just lift the glass off. Isn't that gorgeous? Just look at that. Can you see that? See, it's got those like extended pins. And just slips out, no tools required. And the glass goes in the box. And then it would be the same deal for this big one. Oh, it just lifts up. I'm loving this. Look at that, quite well sealed those. Glasses in the box. Okay, so what do we have? So there's this thumb screw. I think I'm going to really decide where I'm going to put the SSD at. But I do want to have also the option to have fans at the bottom here. So I've already got two SSD locations. I only have one SSD, and I was actually thinking of having it in the back. Look at the instruction, but I think it was possible to put them in the back. Put it in the back. Oh, that's tough. That's not. Oh, it's more. Oi! Heavy. So, slips off. Screw this one also. I think I'm gonna take the. Oh, that was hard. Because I'm not sure what to actually have. And then this also has a magnetic fan filter underneath there. So, let's see now. So, what I thought I'd do now is to actually put the power supply in place. So anyway, I did an unboxing of the power supply I'm using, so if you want to see it, I'll try and put a cord up in one of the monitors. And here's the package for the power supply. With it, so it actually has the installation screws and some zip ties. So I went for a 750-watt power supply. Should be good enough. Now, the air should probably, I would assume, come from this side. Well, since we have an instruction, I will actually just quickly check if that is the case. If they actually have a picture, I can test this. So there's the install that I'm going to use. You get a Corsair sticker. Don't bother to put that on. Yeah, Corsair, if you're listening, if you sponsor this video, then I'll put your tag on. Otherwise, I won't. Look, it even says four-piece PSU. Sorry, I'm muttering to myself, but I will screw these on first, and then I'll show you what I'm talking about. Should those be so hard to screw? I don't understand, because those are the wrong thread, because they go very tight. Supply come with screws that don't work in the power supply screw hole. Okay, let's see what we got with the case then. Sorry about that. Okay, I'm gonna quit out for a while. Anyway, those screws don't seem to work. Let's see. One of the screws that came with the case works. If these don't work. Are they really so tight? No way. No way. What in the world? I'll have to take this out. Simple procedure. That should not be that hard to do on the swoop. Take my PC screw set. So all of them have screw problems. Oh, just having a bad day. It's equally tight. Did they plan it so that they should be so tight? It's not really my experience, but it does say that those are the screws for power supply. Nicely punched though. I must admit that it's been a long time ago since I installed completely new power supplies. Maybe it's just that is just what it is. I was thinking of editing these videos, but then of course one loses all the nice details about how actually it's not that easy. So I'm nice to put these things together. So, Find a screw bit. That's very tight. As I said, I haven't installed that many power supplies, so it's just me being super. And then I have to keep on looking at the camera to see if it's recording the correct stuff. Okay, so let's try and screw that in then somehow. And again, four screws. Actually show the screws. Oops, like that. And then let's see now. The easiest way. Maybe if I... Oops. Not with the fan in. Thank you very much. Okay. Put it like this. Ah, this is a nice case to work with. At least I think so. And it's gonna blow out like that. I want it on the top, pretty much as high as I can get it. So maybe something like there. Let's see how many times I drop the screw. More screws. It's not very easy to position the camera to see exactly what I'm doing, but when I lift it up again, the case, then I can show how these are being bolted. Yeah. So, two screws. Okay, this one's going to be a bit tricky in this corner here. Actually fantastic to be able to remove all the panels and everything. That helps a lot. I think if one needs to fix this thing, just chuck the panels and have access to it. So, what hiccups have we had? Power supply screws were a bit too tight for my liking, but they seem to go in okay. It holds the power supply. Obviously won't shake out, that's for sure. I was not expecting them to be heavy so hard. So, here we go. Could have had them possibly on this side, on the back side here. But maybe I can just actually which way around. Actually, I didn't need to be. Anyway, I can. Can just see where the fan is now positioned. So this is the back side, so I could have actually put it over here, but then we got an issue with the lighting ring, which is here, so I'd like this completely exposed in the inside of the case, so that's a bit of a compromise. think I will leave a little bit of space just so they have nice cable management throughputs here. Oh, it's just so nice. I should send DeBauer, thank God, for watch more of his videos online. Now, if you want to see the unboxing of this case, I also have a video on that. Wait a second. Okay, it's time to put the last fan in. Let's see if I can fit it in here. Let's see what would be the easiest way. Turn this around. Oh, boy. Bag of screws. I must say, I really like this case. I must say, I'm probably a bit over-biased about it. Wasn't sponsored, I had to buy it with my own money. So, let's see now, there are two connectors. One was going to be the chaining. You can chain these fans for the LED. I think if I put it there, it will have enough space to take the cable. Oh, wait, I have to watch that. I have the right airflow direction. So, the same thing I did there, keep the tape on until I've done the build. And I'll take it away. I think when you're building black against black, and it's harder to see. Oops. Too much. So I recommend starting all the screws first, and then positioning it, and then do final tightening. Sit there, because the bottom is out here. Okay, and I'll just keep it there. It's very flexible, this setup for screwing the fans in, because then we can actually put a water radiator here, like that, and you can have a water radiator on the top also if you like. So maybe that'll be for future upgrade videos, so when I go from air cooling to water cooling. So, no, that looks like. And thinking if I should, because now the next thing more clear step would be to get the motherboard populated and installed before one continues. Need to install. This is the LED control box for the fans. Just see if I can actually pre-install. Let's see. Oh, look at that. That kind of fits there. I wonder if we should screw this one on those while we're at it. And we would have this pre-mounted. Section with the cables coming down. I think I'll do that. I'll screw that. And then we can just say that we've actually done that module part at least. The idea is to take this here. Connectors going down. So everything plugs in the hole. And it comes with its own screws. I'm hoping these are the right ones. They should be. And here are some of the cables. Screwdrivers. Assistance. So, let's see. Going to separate the video about installing the components on the motherboard to a separate video. The reason I have a playlist for building this channel PC, if you'd like to look it up. My idea is that people who want to know how to do a certain part of it will just be able to click on the video, which clearly states what it's about. Don't have to watch through videos and scroll through and try to find the specific detail. See? Oh, it fits in there nicely. And it's going on there like that. And this one goes back in. And the SSD is going to go up here. This thing on the trunk right there. Shouldn't it be in the way, should it? No, because those cables could come out there. As I said, we might need to move things around. It's not always a guarantee that things will fit. So we'll see when I get to the storage. Storage part. So anyway, that summarizes that. Garbage. It's a pity with this instruction book, but it's a very nice instruction book, but they mashed it into the container, so now it's all just... Anyway, to summarize what has been happening, took all the panels off the case. As you see, you can make it very open. We installed the power supply. Had a few issues that I thought the screws were too tight, but they seemed to fit anyway. And then installed three fans. So there's the two fans. And then here's the last one down here in the bottom. And and then put the lead controlled box on the this back panel port. And that's it. So in the next video I will demonstrate how to set up the motherboard and possibly even install it in the case. See how it logically connects together. If you found this interesting, consider subscribing and hit the bell to get notified for the next video, because then if you want to pick up and follow the whole build through, then you could actually just watch that when it comes up. And see everybody in the next one.